Chuck Brown, the pastor here at St. Timothy. We are so excited to have vocal authority from Bethel University in McKenzie, Tennessee, here to sing for us this evening. They are under the direction of Peter Jeffrey. Reverend Peter Jeffrey is a Cumberland Presbyterian minister, and he helps run the Renaissance program, the music program at Bethel University. We're glad to have you all here, and we'll look forward to hearing from you now. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you. is dying.
On the cross where our Lord is dying,
Yahweh, Jesus is dying.
Solar reflective panel, but that's just the way it goes, I guess. It's great to be here. We've been looking forward to this night for a long time, and I know Mitch has been looking forward to this night for a long time, right, Mitch? The answer is yes. Yes. Okay. Good. This is a group called Vocal Authority from the Renaissance Program at Bethel University, and we're very excited about this project. We started it last year. And they've really done well. These are 16 of our finest singers, incredible musicians, and we put this together with the idea that we would be able to do different kinds of things, different kinds of venues, be a little more compact group, and also that this group would be able to dig into some pretty difficult stuff. And they are fine singers. They don't call them Vocal Authority for nothing. So I want to just thank you for having us here tonight, and we're going to take you in a lot of different musical directions, but that's just what we love to do. So we're going to sing a whole bunch more gospel music and some secular music and some funny things and everything else in between. But right now, I want to let them do a little bit of showing off for you. This is a little song called Ride the Chariot.
You ready for the journey? one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, when the blues won't haunt you anymore. We're brave, we're free, and love is sore. We'll rise and lead to the west of the shore. We won't hesitate to bring down the God in the day. There's not much time.
Before we do anything else, I wanted you to get to know exactly who these young people are. They do a phenomenal job juggling the responsibilities of Renaissance, which includes up to 3 hours of practice daily, which is a lot of practice time, and traveling on the weekends and going out over spring break. This is a trip that started last Saturday. We drove from McKenzie to Houston. That was a long drive. And then we did the morning worship at the Houston First Church, and then Stone Oak and San Antonio Sunday night, and then we went to Corpus Christi on Monday, and then Odessa, and then Lubbock, and then Albuquerque, and then all the way back over here. And so we've been covering some territory. But it's a great way to spend spring break, isn't it? Absolutely. But they do work hard. They're required to work hard. They earn a very nice scholarship for doing so. That's not the only reason they do this. Each one of them has a great passion for music and for performing, and many of them will go on to see very successful careers in music. We have some that are not going to pursue a career in music, but music will always be a big part of their life. And wherever they go, the work ethic and the professionalism will come out in everything that they do. So I'm very proud of them. So let's get it started right over here. Why don't we?
Hello, everybody. My name is Kayla Clanton, and I'm from Greenfield, Tennessee, and my major is education.
Hi, everybody. My name is Chad McFarland, and I'm from Nashville, Tennessee, and I'm a music education major.
I'm Melody Merle, and I'm from Red Bay, Alabama, and I'm a music education major.
I'm Rachel Barnes, I'm from Memphis, Tennessee, and I'm a vocal performance major.
Hi, my name is Carmen Myers, I'm from Jackson, Tennessee, and I'm a vocal performance major.
I'm Shelby Carpenter, I'm from Paris, Tennessee, and I'm a pre-physicians assistant major.
I'm Rebecca Stewart from Nashville, Tennessee, and I'm a math major.
I'm Henrietta Rice, and I'm from Memphis, Tennessee, and I'm an education major.
Hey everybody, my name is Rodney Ferguson, I'm from Memphis, Tennessee, and I'm a vocal performance major.
Hi, my name is Raphael Morgan, Jackson, Tennessee, and I'm a music production and technology major.
I'm Brian Mead, I'm from Charlotte, Tennessee, and I'm a vocal performance major.
Hi, my name is Mitch Brown, and I'm from here, and I'm a history major.
Yeah!
Hi, my name is John Dyson, I'm from Covington, Tennessee. My major is music industry studies.
Hello, everyone. My name is Daniel Willis, I'm from Nashville, Tennessee, and my major is special education.
Hello everyone, my name is Joshua Randall. I'm from Nashville, Tennessee, and I'm a vocal performance major.
And I'm Lamar Bowen from South Haven, Mississippi, and I'm a vocal performance major also.
Sitting on that chair right there playing the guitar, he is from New Johnsonville, Tennessee, because the old Johnsonville just wasn't good enough for him. And he is a physical education major. And his name is Derek Brassfield. And then sitting next to him is a Christian theology major from Huntington, Tennessee. The man that plays only one note at a time. That is Zach Hardy. And then in the fishbowl, we have from Jackson, Tennessee, one of the newest members of this group, and a fine musician, plays many instruments, and is doing an awesome job. Let's see. You're a music major, right? Yes, that is correct. I can almost see you inside there. That is Byron Chaney. And then, yeah, you can clap your hands. And then way back there in the back, we have a few others. They don't get noticed very much. I tell them, and it's just like referees in basketball. If we don't notice you, that means you're doing an awesome job. So, in the red right there, he is from Lenore City, Tennessee, and that is Christian Marquez, sitting right in the middle, the rose between the thorns. She's from Troy, Tennessee. She's actually already finished one degree. That wasn't enough for her. She had to get another one. She's getting a master's in education, and that is Courtney Barnett. And then, from Memphis, Tennessee, I still haven't learned your major yet. I'm sorry. I'll get it. That is Ricky Mitchell. So give them a big hand for doing all this stuff. And now, we're going to do something a little different. Brian, why don't you tell them about it?
What What is love? Love is like oxygen. Love is a many splendored thing. Love lifts us up where we belong. All you need is love. That doesn't really answer our question. But we're going to tell you a love story as only Renaissance can. A love story in four parts. The four stages of love. Stage one. Wow.
Together.
stage four.
I'm sorry.
So sorry.
So sorry. Please accept my apology. They say love is blind. I guess I was just too blind to see.
Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, hit the road, Jack.
about that. Benny, going there. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going there. Oh my Lord. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going there. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going there. Oh my Lord. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going there. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going. Everybody talking about that. Benny, going there. Oh my Lord.
Well, I've read about the streets of gold, and I've read about the throne. And everybody calling the Lord, Lord, is gonna see that heavenly home.
Everybody talking about that. Benny, going there.
Risk a train wreck. We were asked if we could do this particular number that we worked up for the Christmas show. It is a Christmas song. It's called The 12 Days of Christmas. It's a very interesting arrangement of that. We don't have second sopranos, so for those of you with musically trained ears, you'll probably cringe when you don't hear the second sopranos. But we think maybe we can do it. Maybe. So if a train wreck's in the middle, just let a train wreck and start over again. It's okay. All right? Okay, so you guys just be cheerleaders over there, okay? Okay, good.
Ten
Oh,
Well, we've got time for a couple more songs tonight. But before we do those, we would like to express our extreme thanks to you for having us here tonight. It is a good place to be on Saturday night. There's a lot of other places we could be on Saturday night, and this is a good one, I think. I appreciate all of you braving the monsoon to get here. I'm from Seattle, Washington, and this is just nothing. You know, this is just a light sprinkle. But we really do appreciate it. Bethel University has always been a very special place, and it's always produced some very special people, and some of them are in this room right now. Bethel has grown considerably. I think it is absolutely God's will for it to do so. I think that we have a unique ministry. I think that that Bethel has a unique vision and a unique purpose in the world of higher education. It seems like in higher education, the more you look around, the more you see that either the education is being watered down or you have to put up with some incredible moral decay in order to get through and get a good quality education. I believe that that Bethel has a unique vision and a unique purpose where more and more and more incredible people can come through and fulfill the purpose that God has for them in their lives. I know that doesn't necessarily mean 100% of them will, but as a really good friend once told me, he said, you know, you can't save all of them, but you're obligated to save the ones that are dropped on your porch. And I really believe that God has an uncanny way of bringing people to this place, and I know I've experienced that in Renaissance just year after year after year, where God brings unique talents and unique personalities and sometimes reclamation projects and sometimes just people with so much incredible talent and everything in between. And God expects us to help guide and to help mold and to help encourage and to help prod and allow God to create an environment where God can really work in young people's lives. And that's what we're doing. That's what Bethel is doing. Bethel is now the third fastest growing private institution in the country, which I think is pretty phenomenal. Some people sort of are made a little bit nervous by something being the fastest growing anything, because it's always get a little nervous that, well, maybe it won't stay the way it's supposed to be. But you know, when you have a unique ministry and God sees something in the people that are working in that ministry, it just makes sense for more and more and more young people to be able to take advantage of that ministry. And that happens as we're able to connect with you and you lend your support in every possible way, whether it be through prayers and encouragement or whether it be through showing up in a rainstorm on a Saturday night. It means something. It really does mean something. We always identify ourselves as a connectional church, but sometimes, you know, we can feel a little bit disconnected. But times like this, we can come together and realize that God's not only working in this church, but God is working through Cumberland Presbyterians in the whole world. And it's really important for us to sit down every now and then and just remember that. And I can foresee a vision for the future that includes many young people that are right here. Some are in this room right now. Some we haven't reached yet, but many, many young people coming through with such a unique perspective on life and so many unique talents that have been developed where in other academic institutions, those kinds of talents are sometimes frowned upon. So thank you for coming, and thank you for lending us your support. Thank you for continuing to lend us your support, because it really does mean the world to us. And thank you for taking care of us with food tonight and with housing for tonight and everything else that you do. Yes, you can absolutely show your appreciation tonight. These are some of the most special people in the world, and I love every one of them. And I look forward to seeing what else God has in store.